I think it's magnificent the way that objects can evoke our memories. This 1970s yellow plastic skateboard reminds me of church, believe it or not. And the Sony Walkman, before there was an iPad or an iPod or an MP3 player, there was the Sony Walkman, then the Sony Discman. This object actually reminds me of the day I converted to Christianity and gave my life over to Jesus Christ. You know, the skateboard is something that reminds me of church. And the reason for that is that I grew up in a little farming community in upstate New York, about 100 miles from New York City, along the Hudson River. And in our town, we didn't have a lot of paved roads, but the church in our town, the Beekman United Methodist Church, had a graveyard behind the church, and it had the best paved roads in town. So I used to take the skateboard, and Sunday afternoons I'd ride all through the church graveyards. Interesting thing about that is I'd never went to church growing up, although my parents had me baptized in that very church on September 26, 1967, when I was 3 months old. They never took me to church. We didn't pray. We weren't involved in any kind of religious activity. So my life was spent really waiting for the next skateboarder magazine to come out as a 10-year-old and skateboarding behind the church in the graveyard. The irony of that, of course, for me was that my ancestors had been buried in that church since the 1740s. And every single chance I got, I was rolling by them, really as a person who was spiritually dead, rolling by dead people as a spiritually dead person with no understanding of what it would mean to have hope in your life or a savior. Skateboard also reminds me of my mom's church going. I love skateboarding, and around the time I got my skateboard as a 10-year-old, my mother started going to church. And before long, she started announcing to our family that she had become a born-again Christian. And there was nothing more horrible that I could ever have heard than that my mother was, quote-unquote, a born-again. It started just with her taking us to church, then holding Bible studies in our homes. Before long, there were bumper stickers on the back of our mid-70s town and country station wagon that said things like, "Christians aren't perfect, just forgiven," or "My best friend is a Jewish carpenter." And I was horrified by that. I wanted to be a cool kid who was pretending that he could live a life in the country like a skateboarder from Dogtown in the uplands of California. And as the years went by, my mother stayed with this Christianity. It stuck. And as I was riding my yellow skateboard through the graveyard, my mom was getting her freedom from a yellow highlighter in her New Revised Standard Version Bible. This is it right here. This is the Bible that I would wake up every morning and go downstairs to get ready for school, and I'd see it open, new yellow highlighting. Oftentimes there'd be tears drying on the pages or spilt coffee. And really, you know, the reason why I eventually came to become a Christian was because this story, this Savior who brought my mother from death to life, changed her, and it changed my family. It changed the way we lived. It changed the way my parents loved me. And so it's a skateboard that reminds me of church growing up, a yellow skateboard. It's a yellow Walkman that reminds me, however, of my conversion to Christ. You see, when I was 13 years old, I had heard enough of Jesus and enough of the fact that he loved me despite that I was a sinner from Pastor Wickstead in our local church and my mom in our evening Bible studies that I really couldn't shake it. And it was 2 weeks before my 14th birthday. School had let out. I was an eighth grader going into a ninth grade. I had all the coolest friends. I was the captain of the cross country team, and I was hanging out with kids that were really doing crazy things and getting me to do crazy things. And I remember the day I was pushing my BMX bike down the highway with a Sony Walkman plugged in, and I was listening to AC/DC's Back in Black album. And I had it all the way up, and I had an amazing religious experience. My bike had gotten a flat tire, and I was pushing it, and I was listening to this music that was so dark. And I heard Jesus say to me, "Jay, if you keep living this way, if you keep rejecting me, your life is going to end terribly." And I listened to him. I knew that he was right. I knew that I needed a savior for my sins, and I needed a master of my life, because my life was out of control, even as a 13-year-old boy. So I turned it off. I turned the tape off, and I yielded to Jesus. I went home that day. I remember telling my parents that I had finally relented and decided to follow Jesus. I had become a born again, and that really was the beginning of a beautiful relationship that has carried on for the last 35 years. So it is incredible the way objects can evoke memories. Spin the wheels of a skateboard, and I'm reminded of church as a little kid. Show me a Walkman, and I think about the day I got saved.